Your introduction. Let me talk about the background and purposes of the present study. Recovery of spectral reflectances of objects being imaged through the use of image data is very important to reproduce color images under various illuminations. Although when estimation is usually used for the recovery, but the recovery performance of this estimation depends on the autocorrelation matrix of the spectral reflectances and noise present in the image acquisition system. Is this a pointer? The spectral reflectance of and some objects from the sensor responses can be recovered by applying Wiener filter to sensor response P. The Wiener filter is expressed by this equation, and RSS is a autocorrelation matrix of the spectral reflectances of the imaged objects, and SL is a system matrix that containing the spectral sensitivities are multiplied with illuminations. And here, REE represents the noise covariance matrix. And usually, the noise covariance matrix is expressed by simple formula. This represents the noise variance, and I represents the identity matrix. This graph shows MSE as a function of the noise variance used for the estimation. This axis represents MSE. MSE is defined by this equation. Here, R is actual reflectance, and R hat is recovered spectral reflectance. And square of the Euclidean norm average for all reflectances. As you can see from this graph, MSE is minimized at actual noise variance. So it is very important to find or estimate the actual noise variance. I have already proposed a model to estimate the noise variance of the image acquisition system and a method to recover the spectral reflectances without prior knowledge of the object. In the previous model, the noise was assumed independent, identically distributed random variables over each channel. However, noise variance of each channel is not always equal. This slide shows the concept of the noise variance estimation in the previous model. Let R be actual spectral reflectance, and let R hat be recover spectral reflectance. The MSE of the recover spectral reflectance is defined by this equation. When we apply the Wiener filter with zero noise variance to pixel value, then MSE at zero noise variance can be expressed by this equation. Here, square of the sigma represents the actual noise variance of the image acquisition system. So noise variance can be estimated by using this equation. Here, MSE0 can be obtained by experiment, and other factors can be computed if spectral sensitivity of the multispectral camera and spectral power distribution of the illumination and spectral reflectances of the training samples are previously known. By applying the estimated noise variance and spectral reflectances of the training sample to the filter, spectral reflectances of the test sample can be recovered without a prior knowledge of the test samples. The purposes of the presentation are to propose a new model for the estimation of the noise covariance matrix without the assumption that noise variance of each channel is equal in multispectral camera. And second is to show that the new proposal is very important for the analysis of multispectral image acquisition system. This slide shows the concept of the noise covariance estimation by the new model. Let R be actual spectral reflectance, and let R hat be the estimated noise reflectance. When a filter with zero noise covariance matrix is applied to sensor signals, then the autocorrelation matrix of the difference between R and R hat average for all reflectances is expressed in this equation. The autocorrelation matrix at zero noise covariance matrix is expressed by this equation from the mathematical analysis. And here, REE represents the actual noise covariance matrix of the image acquisition system. So it is possible to estimate the noise covariance matrix by this equation. Here, this term is a factor can be obtained by experiment, and other factors can be calculated by using the spectral characteristics of the sensors, illuminations, and reflectances of the training sample. By using the estimated noise covariance matrix and spectral reflectances of training sample to the filter, spectral reflectances of the test sample can be recovered without a prior knowledge of the test samples. Experiment performed with these conditions. This figure shows the spectral sensitivities used for the image acquisition, and this figure shows the spectral power distribution used for the illumination. This is a typical example of the estimated covariance matrix. This diagonal element is a some kind of noise variance of each channel. This indicates the first channel's noise variance, and this indicates the second channel's noise variance. This is a typical example of the recovered spectral reflectances when the same samples are used for tests and training samples. The green mark represents the actual spectral reflectance, and red mark represents the recovered spectral reflectance with estimated noise covariance matrix proposed in this presentation. And this blue mark represents the recovered spectral reflectance by the previous model. This table shows the comparison of the recovery performance between previous and present model. The first and the second row show the experimental result when the same sample used for training and test samples. And third and the fourth row show the experimental results when test samples are different from training samples. This column shows the experimental results by the previous model, and this column shows the MSE by this new proposal. When the same sample used for training and test sample, recovery performance of the new model that is estimated by the noise covariance matrix is superior to previous model. However, the recovery performance of this new model is inferior when the test samples are different from training samples. From the experimental result, it is concluded that covariance matrix estimated by the proposal overfits the covariance matrix to learning sample. Therefore, recovery performance is inferior to previous model when the test sample are different from training sample. However, this overfitting means that estimates of the covariance matrix are correctly performed using the proposed model. Since in this proposal, noise covariance matrix can be estimated, so it is possible to evaluate the value of the diagonal element as a function of the average signal power in each channel. From this experimental result, it may be said the value of the diagonal element it is equivalent to the noise variance of each channel is independent on the average signal power in each channel. This graph shows the trace of the estimated noise covariance matrix divided by the channel number, which is equivalent to the average noise variance for all channels as a function of the sampling intervals and bit depth of the quantization from the analog signals to digital signal. From this experiment, the result, the mean noise variance increases with decrease in the bit depth below the 8-bit depth. As you can see, difficult to distinguish between the 10-bit and 8-bit, but this value slightly increased when bit depth decreases from 10-bit to 8-bit. And the sampling interval dependence is like this, and the mean noise variance increases with the increase in the sampling number longer than 20 nanometers. In conclusion, a new model is proposed for the estimation of the covariance matrix of the system noise of color image acquisition. The system noise is largely uncorrelated with pixel value, and it is not identically distributed in each channel. Since covariance matrix estimated by the proposal overfits the matrix to learning samples, the recovery performance for the test sample is poor compared with the previous model, when test samples are different from learning samples. However, this overfitting means that the estimates of the covariance matrix are correctly performed using the proposed model. The proposal is very important for noise analysis of an image acquisition system. Thank you for your attention.
So thank you for your presentation. Questions? So I presume that you use linear relationships for obtaining your sensor response output in terms of the luminance, reflectances, and sensor sensitivities. So you fix, it's like to fix the exposure time. Have you tried what happens with your model if you change the exposure time?
It independent on the integration time of the CCD. And we use value of the exposure in the linear portion of the...
Within the linear?
Yes, yes.
Okay. But not out of the linear region?
But if the over the linear region is used, we collect it to linear, linearly by using the lookup table. If the intensity of light incident on CCD is increases, the non-linear region of the CCD must be used. But at that time, we use a correct non-linearity to linear relations.
Okay, thank you again. Thank you.